Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. In this short video, I will give you tutorial how to use the circuit breaker that you can see on the screen. In power system, circuit breaker is a passive device which is controlled with the help of a relay. In case of a fault, when relay will sense the fault, it will give signal to the breaker to trip. And in the same way, the recloser relay or reclosing mechanism of the relay would reclose the contacts. Here, to implement the same idea in power system lab, we use this breaker. There are two ways to operate the circuit breaker. One is a manual operation. Here you can see, if I press this on button, the circuit breaker is on, and if I press off, it will turn off the circuit breaker. So here on and off lights can also be used to have the indication about the circuit breaker status. This is on, this is off. We want to control the circuit with the help of the relay. Here if I show you this point, it is written that relay input, okay, and over there we can see PLC. The same circuit breaker which you people may have used in your power system analysis lab, you have used it manually. It can also be controlled with the help of relay and PLC. If we want to use it manually, these two points are short circuited. So these point will be short circuit for relay as well as for PLC. But if we want to control the circuit breaker with the help of relay or PLC, we will remove the short circuit and then use the relay contact over here. It means this operation on and off is only possible if the PLC and the relay both contacts are short circuited. Let me close this circuit breaker and then open this relay terminal. Here you will see, as soon as I will remove the shunt, circuit breaker will become off. And if I try to turn on the circuit breaker, I will not be able to close the contacts. Reason, because the relay contact is open. If I put the shunt back and press on button, now again circuit breaker on off is possible. If it is in this condition, closed condition, and if I open this terminal, the circuit breaker automatically will become off. Now from this we have concluded that if the normally closed contact of the relay are connected across this relay terminal, on the tripping of the relay, normally closed contact will become open. So that is equivalent to making these two terminals open. So relay would cause the tripping of the circuit breaker. So this is how circuit breaker will be controlled with the help of a relay. Here I will show you how to connect the circuit breaker with the relay so that relay can control the circuit breaker operation in case of a fault. Here with the help of this relay, I will control the circuit breaker operation. In order to connect the circuit breaker relay terminal with the normally closed contact of the relay, here I will insert these two terminal of these connecting wire over here, and with the help of this banana connector, I will make connection with normally closed. In normal condition, these two contacts are closed, so that's why now it is a short circuit across the relay contacts. Now if I press start and stop button, I can have the manual operation of the circuit breaker. Now when the relay will trip, it will also result in tripping of the circuit breaker. Let's see how. Here I have closed the circuit breaker. Now I am going to set this relay. This is under and over voltage relay, so I will set this relay to perform in under voltage condition, as there is no voltage applied across these two terminals. As soon as I will complete the setting on receiving 0 voltage over here, relay would trip. So let me do the settings. Controller mode, under voltage relay. So let's set this voltage to 20 volt, let's set. Enter, make it DMT. And operating time, let's set it equal to 3 seconds. Now as soon as I am going to press this enter, setting will complete for the relay. There is no voltage across the relay. Relay would trip and make its normally closed contact open and normally open contact close. Observe closely to the circuit breaker. Here after delay of 3 seconds, relay normally closed contact has become open and circuit breaker has become off. Now you can see on term light is off and off light has become on. So that is indication of the circuit breaker has tripped. Now in this condition, if I try to close the circuit breaker by pressing the on button, I would not be able to do that. Reason, because the relay has tripped and there is a transition of its contacts. In order to reclose the circuit breaker, I will have to reset the relay. Here I am going to reset the relay. Relay has been reset. Now if I press on button, now circuit breaker is closed. Okay, so you people are going to correct all the circuit breaker with some appropriate relay in order to control those circuit breaker with relay. On tripping of the relay, circuit breaker contacts will become open. There is one more instruction to use the circuit breaker. As you can see, the rated current of this circuit breaker is 3 ampere. Means their contacts are designed to interrupt 3 ampere maximum. But here in many experiments, fault current can be as high as 6 ampere or even 7 ampere. So in order to protect the circuit breaker against that fault, because majority of those experiments which require current above 3 ampere are single phase experiment. So we connect these three contacts in parallel with each other. I will show you how we are going to connect in parallel. So here the input is connected in parallel. Similarly, on the other end, we connect these contacts in parallel. Now the circuit breaker is no more a three-phase circuit breaker. It will become a single-phase circuit breaker, where the capability of circuit breaker has increased by 3 times. Now current will get divided into 3 branches. So input a point over here, output will taken from the other end. So that will come in series in that way. So use the circuit breaker in this manner if the fault current is greater than 3 ampere in that particular experiment. If fault current is not above 3 ampere, use the circuit breaker as it is a 3-phase circuit breaker. So this configuration will protect the circuit breaker against high fault current. Thank you very much.